Hello, everyone. I'd like to thank you for joining us today for today's sermon from Praise Assembly of God here at 89 Congress Street. Hope you enjoy this message, and if you have any feedback you'd like to offer, feel free to give me a call at 207-364-3856 or my cell phone, 207-357-4748. Again, enjoy today's message. Thanks. We do a special talent night every 3 months, and so here we are for the fall season, and we have a couple of special things that we're going to get to tonight with the Bible verse competition as well as the baby competition, baby picture competition. So we're going to have a great night tonight, and then we have quite a few people signed up. So I'm going to open us with a word of prayer, a couple of announcements, and then we'll get right into the festivities because we have a full load tonight to get to. But first, before we have prayer, if you guys can remember my father-in-law, he was admitted. My wife just texted me tonight to CMMC with bleeding on the brain again. And they're doing an EKG, and he's starting to have some mini seizures. So this afternoon when we got home from church, he was numbness in the right side of his body, very tipsy, slurred speech. And so Mary took him straight to CMMC this afternoon, and couldn't find someone to help us out with our horses as well as the two horses. Tony's going to come and sing a song called God's Not Dead. Praise the Lord. He's going to come. And Tony's been going through the ringer with his health this summer and fall, but he's going to give a valiant effort. Praise the Lord. And God's Not Dead. And this is a great song. He's surely alive, living on the inside, roaring like a lion. Praise the Lord.
Now, some people may think, some people who are non-Christian may think God's not dead. Well, he's not. He's alive inside us. And he's alive here, amen?
Amen.
Somehow, now I'm lost in.
shake the ground with the sound of revival. The heaven roar, come fire fall. Come shake the ground with the sound of revival.
Everybody! not. Praise be to God. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. Cindy's going to come now and sing. She has, I think, two songs, but you can't. Okay, so she's going to come and sing one song here that Brandon will cue up for you.
Which one? Broken
Into Pieces. This year, I've had a lot of illness in my life, and we have a God that heals. And He healed me overnight from a really serious digestive problem that I had. And He can heal anyone. He can heal your illness. He can heal you from addiction. He can heal a relationship. And it's all through having a relationship with Jesus.
Amen. Amen. That's exciting.
That's okay. Yeah. So,
he had them all cued, and I closed them on accident, so he's having to recue them all up again. What happens when he has to take a bathroom?
This song kind of has a patriotic twist to it. I make my own videos, and I did it like about 3 months ago, and the Lord told me on Wednesday that He wanted me to do the whole thing, and I don't know why, but it's got a patriotic tribute to him, tone to it.
Satisfied, empty and too full.
the wire connecting the soundboard to the laptop and just push that back in. I think it's probably a little loose. My old computer's seen the frost of a few winters, and so sometimes it gets ajar. So that's where that static's coming from. Praise the Lord. All right, Sylvia. Sylvia's going to come, and she is an awesome gymnastic little star here. All right, so Sylvia's going to come and show us some of her talents. All right, praise the Lord.
Beautiful, we're the same.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Give me a high five, Sylvia. That is dynamite. Praise the Lord. Pushed it too far back. Amen. I tell you what, that is good stuff right there. Amen. Any of you guys remember gymnastics back when you were that young? 7, 8 years old? Wow. Great job, Sylvia. Great job. Lori Lynn's going to come and sing for us now. Just you this time. Yep. All right.
Praise the Lord. I don't know about any of you, but there's times we just go through trials. And the song I want to sing, first I want to read a scripture. It's in 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Verse, I just lost it. Alright, well, the song I want to sing is that when answers aren't enough, there's Jesus. Amen. And there's actually two songs. And the other one is, It Was Enough. I still can't find that verse. Praise the Lord. I was going to say how that Jehoshaphat was going to go into this battle. And the armies all around him, they were just too great for him. And the Lord said, you don't need to fight in this battle. That the battle, he's already won. It's not ours, but it's the Lord's. And we can just look to Jesus.
Enough, he's there.
ways that weigh me down each day and steal my sleep at night. Heard I read about a peace I wish I felt. How can you forgive me when I can't forgive myself? It was enough, the blood that you shed.
Explain what this has been so everybody knows what we're going to do here.
Our Bible contest is every 2 weeks a Bible verse is put up on the board, and once it's memorized, if you want to tell the pastor, myself, or Vince, we write your name down, and there's a prize for whoever remembers the most Bible verses.
The prize here tonight is they have to cite those verses, and then do I give a prize for those that had points that came to me and to you and to Vince?
You can give a prize to the ones who know them and don't want to get up.
Okay, I got you. I got you now. All right, so anyone, I had, I think it was 7 people that came and cited. Does anybody want to cite here? And just as a reward, I've got a couple of $10 coupons to McDonald's. So anybody want to go? If you cite to me behind closed doors, you get a $5. $10. I got a couple of them who wants to roll with these verses. Anybody? Yeah, come on up, Mindy. Come on up. Take a chance here. You were one of the ones that came to me for some points earlier.
No, I don't do well under pressure, guys.
Under pressure. Yeah, come on up here. You got to come on up. Yeah. Now that McDonald's got some people moving out now. All right, so here we got two right here. My two prize winners, all right? Who wants to go first? You want to say ladies first? Oh, you want to go first? Oh, all right. All right, maybe pressure's on.
Yeah, I'm really happy. Either way, it's good,
and of course, we're taking
with the
goal. All right. So I don't have the list with me, though.
I don't either.
My
first one is John 3:16.
Son, so that all who believe in him shall have eternity, life, and shall not perish.
All right, that's close. That's pretty good.
I did better when I recited it to you, huh?
Yes.
No pressure, that's why.
All right, turn it up.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Now, Proverbs 29:25. Both of you cited this to me as well. Proverbs 29:25. And I'm in a nice giving mood. My students will tell you I'm in a giving mood every now and then. All right, I'll start it off.
The fear of man brings a snare.
I know there's a second piece to this.
There is.
But God helps by strengthening the man. That's not the verse, but it's the gist of it. I can summarize.
Vega, can you remember it?
He does too. Yes, he does. I just gave you the first half.
The fear of man
brings a snare. Let the gift of God brings eternal life.
No, that's the fear of man brings a snare, but whoever trusts in the Lord shall be
strengthened.
Strengthened, yes.
See?
Be strengthened.
Should have given me a little bit more.
All right. Now, the last one that you guys came to me was Isaiah 40:29.
I think after this one, that's all I know.
Yeah, that's all.
But if you're going with hints, I can roll with the punches.
Isaiah 40:29, he gives power.
And to those that are power to the weak and to those that are mighty.
Psalm 25:4. That's the one for this.
Psalm 25:4. Show me
your ways, O Lord.
Very good, Zadok. Very good.
I think you only had the three. John, Proverbs, and Isaiah. I think. But I'm going to be nice and we'll give it to you anyway. There you go. All right. Any of those that wanted to tackle them, because they were our big participants for the first piece, but we, $10, that's two Big Mac meals or something, you know? So, all right. So, thank you. Well, we're going to shift to poetry, which is actually my favorite. So Mariah's going to come. She has a poem that she is going to share with us here tonight. Okay.
I'm not sure if she's here, but the first poem is actually pretty much for Miss Mary, pastor's wife.
No. Well, she's at the hospital with her father.
Well.
We're recording it, so she'll see.
Okay, so obviously the pastor's wife. In the shadow of the personage stands a figure oft obscure. Just behind the faithful pastor is his wife, devout and pure.
She is with him every moment, helping make his work progress, and you can't discount her portion in his measure of success.
Oft behind the scene of action, often never seen or heard, yet she stands forever ready just to give a helping word. It is not in active service that her worth is really shown, but in bearing heavy burdens that to others are unknown.
With encouragement and verse vision that she must urge God's servant on when the shadows are the darkest and his courage almost gone. With her home forever open and her work quite near, never done. She is ever his lieutenant in the battles fought and won.
Amen. Okay. That was my PR buzzer. Obviously, I have to give him the credit, but I thought that was fitting. Now, do you want to do yours with my help since we're right here? All right, so here's one. She's going to do actually two that would be fitting too.
Try my best because I'm still learning. If I can send some thought out into God's pure air, his wings of love will speed it on to help someone somewhere. If I can say a kindly word, if I can only buy one, it is heard. It may take root and in the a loving heart and kindness to other in part. If I can do a kind deed, although 'tis small, is as a mustard seed, it may grow and grow and grow. until it blossoms. Blessings only God will know. So let me be kind of from day to day, smiling on others along the way. And when the light of day is gone, I will feel and I will have to, I will feel and I will I have to try to help someone.
Real quick, this is fitting. She's a teen, and this is going to go out to all the other teens, and probably the preteens and the rest of the little kids that can get it, because it's obviously called Teen Commandments.
Okay, number one, don't let your parents down, they bring you up. Number two, choose your companions with care. You become what they are. Number three, be master of your habits, or they will master you. Number four, treasure your time. Don't spend it invested. Number five, stand for something or you'll fall for anything. Number six, select only a date when who would make a good mate. I'm sorry. Number seven. See what you can do for others, not what they can do for you. Number eight. Guard your thoughts. What do you think? What you think you are. Number nine. Don't fill up on this world's crumbs. Feed your soul on living bread. Number 10, give your all to Christ. He gives his all for you.
Great job, Mariah. Amen. Yeah, you can stay right here.
How many times am I on that thing?
Once.
Just once?
That's what you... Yep.
I might have picked down another
one. All right, well, while you're getting your stuff, let's see. We're going to move. Cindy has a poem she'd like to come and cite. You don't have a poem?
I have a song.
Oh, do you have two more songs? Okay, so we'll come back to you then.
I'm ready, Pastor.
Okay, come on. Yeah, that would be good, Mindy. Yep, that would be just fine.
Amen.
Mindy has an art presentation that accompanies her whole poetry and reading here tonight.
Yeah, actually, I tweaked it a little bit.
Okay.
This is the presentation. Collaging is a big, I love it. And this is pretty much what it is. The back of it are all the bulletins that we get here when we come on Sunday. That's the backdrop. I went through some like highlights, evangels. I got some of my own like Christian womanhood magazines and stuff, and I just found some words. Let me read some of them. Fellowship, big heart, power of prayer, Jesus Christ, Son of God. One of my favorite ones, actually, this bulletin, says all by itself, Jesus answers, which really is awesome from today's sermon. My sheep, I know them, and they follow me. And then the perfect, dot, 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 and each one is special. I got that part out of a magazine. Praise God. Just all kinds, the light of darkness, paradise, revival, of course, that's huge. And I obviously wanted to dedicate this to the actual church. I know Miss Ruthie and a couple other ladies were interested in maybe a copy. I looked into information right across the street, though, $5 and you can get it all copied and post the size and stuff. So if anybody is interested, but I felt it fitting to dedicate this to my home away from home. So wherever pastor, whoever decides to hang it and check it out, there's all kinds of other words. So I just have a few poems. And those are fitting and appropriate too, and they go with everything that you've been preaching and lecturing all your children on.
Yes.
So, real quick, as I can read. Thanksgiving. Let's do this Thanksgiving one. You'll appreciate that, Pastor. It's Thanksgiving, so I figured that was fitting. Thanksgiving Day is the collection, but it is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto thy name, O Most High. That's Psalm 92:1. It's called I Am Thankful. I am thankful to be an American. It is a God-given privilege to dwell in a land where every citizen is free to worship God according to the dictates of his conscience, where everyone can vote in his own political convictions at the polls, where there is freedom of speech and freedom of the press, where there is the free enterprise system under which every person can own property and is not compelled to yield it to a despotic state. Yes, I am grateful to live in a country where there is the God-inspired doctrine that all men are created equal and that every citizen is guaranteed equal justice under the law. I am thankful for our glorious flag. When I behold the stars and stripes, always a tingle of joy, and pride courses through my spinal column with knowledge that this is my flag. And I am overwhelmed with gratitude to Almighty God that as long as this flag ripples in the breezes, all the freedoms which we cherish shall be preserved. This flag represents the spilt blood of my fathers who died to obtain, under God, these freedoms. Forever, let us salute it with the spirit of thanksgiving and with the holy resolve that its enemies shall never haul it down from its lofty ramparts. I am thankful also for the Bible, the book upon which our nation was founded. It is evident to all who know history that America would never have known freedom except for the influence of the Word of God.
Amen.
Today, we would not have one vestige of freedom if the Bible had not been the guidebook and inspiration of our founding fathers. Today, if we were to turn away from the Bible, our country would be another godless Soviet state. Thank God for the Bible. The atheists have bombarded it. The agnostics have ridiculed it. The infidels have blasted it. The skeptics have sought to destroy it. The Roman hierarchy denied it to their people. The modernist preachers have tried to settle it. In fact, all the agencies of Satan have hammered away at it, but it still stands as the imperishable, indestructible word of the eternal God.
Amen.
It still changes lives, transforms homes, elevates communities, blesses nations. Thank God for the Bible. I am thankful for the Church of the Living God. Praise Assembly in general for me. I speak in the true scriptural sense, that assembly of born again, called out ones who have been changed by the power of Christ, who have been made members of the family of God, in spite of false pretenders, misguided religionists, who misinterpret the truth, and willful apostates who seek to deceive the people by advocating the social gospel and by denying the faith. The church goes on, conquering and to conquer, and as our Lord promises, the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. That was written by Neil Crowley. Kareem. He's a great writer. I don't know how many more you have time for, but if you only got, I got one. This is specifically for you, actually. There's two that I really wanted to do because I do. I lost even on my heart.
That's great stuff.
So, we'll do yours first. Because I'll just save some. Okay, this is the one I was reading and jumped out at me, and obviously God laid it on my heart that we absolutely need, I needed to read it so the whole congregation and pastor could hear it. And I think every single one of us can agree to it, and you, pastor, fit the bill. And you know what? As soon as I'm done, you'll get it. It's called What It Takes. On a card in a church in the city of London is to be found the following list of qualifications said to be needed by a pastor. The strength of an ox, the tenacity of a bulldog, the daring of a lion, the patience of a donkey, the industry of a beaver, the versatility of a chameleon, the vision of an eagle, the meekness of a lamb, the hide of a rhinoceros, the disposition of an angel, the resignation of an incurable, the loyalty of an apostle, the heroism of a martyr, the faithfulness of a prophet, the tenderness of a shepherd, the fervency of an evangelist, and the devotion of a mother. And for that, I thank you greatly because you are a huge inspiration and you speak to me for God through you. And without you, I don't think that God could have got here. He probably could have because he's God, but you know what I mean. Probably would have taken way longer. But I want to thank you. And I don't know how the conversation is going. Thanks be to God that we have an amazing pastor. And the wife that is behind him. One more. This is because when people need vacations, like pastor and a wife, he's extremely busy. He's got a baby coming. I know that many of us have said Jesus is there 24/7. And that's right. And eventually, even the stubborn ones are going to have to give Pastor a break when he has his baby.
That's right.
So, I figured this is also fitting. And it's called, Have You Taken It to Jesus? Have you taken it to Jesus? Have you left your burden there? Does he tenderly support you? Have you rolled on him your care? Oh, the sweet unfailing refuge of the everlasting arms. In their loving clasp enfolded, nothing worries or alarms. Have you taken it to Jesus, just the thing that's pressing now? Are you trusting him completely with the when and where and how? Oh, the joy of full surrender of our life, our plans, our all, proving far above our asking that God answers when we call. Have you taken it to Jesus? 'Tis the only place to go. If you want the burden lifted and a solace for your woe, oh, the blessedness to nestle like a child upon his breast, finding ever, as he promised, peace, comfort, peace, and rest. Bye, Mrs. Leo Hensick.
Thank you, Mindy. Amen. Thank you for this time. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Linda's going to come. She has a poem she's going to share. You need the book, too. Yes. I love the poetry. We certainly appreciate while they're coming. Mary and I certainly appreciate your support and your prayer. I think this is our last poem, so we have our poetry section.
I like it. I'm glad you're reading it out loud.
Amen. You'll do just fine, Linda. You'll do just fine.
God's Hall of Fame. It's about rewards. Okay. Your name might not appear down here in this world Hall of Fame. In fact, you may be so unknown that no one knows your name. The Oscars here may pass you by in neon lights of blue. But if you love and serve the Lord, then I have news for you. This Hall of Fame is only good as long as time shall be. But keep it in your mind, God's Hall of Fame is for eternity. To have your name inscribed up there is greater, yes, my father, than all the Halls of Fame down here and every man-made star. This crowd on earth, they soon forgot the heroes of the past. They cheer like mad until you fall, and that's how long you'll last. But God, he never does forget in his Hall of Fame. But just believing in his son, the scribe, you'll find your name. I'll tell you, friend, I wouldn't trade my name, however small, that's written there beyond the stars in the celestial hall, for every famous name on earth or glory that they share. I'd rather be an unknown here and have my name up there.
Amen.
Amen. I'm fine. I know I underlined it.
I think you highlighted the whole page.
No, I didn't. It's okay, man. You're lucky, I love you. All right, okay. The reason. If our lives were always easy, if no troubles came our way, if each day was filled with gladness, we might then neglect to pray. So when sorrow crowds our pathway, when our woes seem multiply, it may be God's way to draw us back again to his side.
Wonderful poem. Wonderful poem. We're going to get back to our young people. Sydney and Lexi are going to come. They have a song now that they're going to sing for us here. Amen. Is Violet coming too, or is it just the two? She's coming too. All right. We're watching these girls grow up right before our very eyes, aren't we, church? And they're growing up so fast. But they're going to sing a song for us.
Thank you, girls. Amen. We are kings and queens inside here. Praise the Lord. The LeClaire family is going to come now and sing a song for us. I don't know if it's just Mike and Sharon or if Felicity's joining him or not. She is. All right, so that means she's got to take orders from headquarters there, Felicity. Amen. Amen. And if one of you can grab the orange, are you going to stay here? Do you want everybody there?
Thank you.
nothing like family singing together. Reminds me of home all the time. Praise the Lord. And speaking of families, we have a sibling team. Tony and Mariah are going to come now, and they're going to sing for us a song, Not Gonna Die. Stuff.
you need music for this one or no?
It's on the, yeah.
It is a YouTube one?
Yeah, it's going to be a...
What's the name of it?
Lord, I need a miracle today. We start with giving glory to God, and everybody's, we need a miracle. We have a lot of healing that needs to go on, and I'm looking in Luke chapter 1, verse 37. It says, "But with God, nothing will be impossible."
Amen.
Church called Where No Man Stands Alone, and
Many of you know that the Lord blessed us this year, not only with the conception of a baby, but with a new home. And June 2nd, everything came together. But when you have a lot of, I have a lot of folks I work with and a lot of friends and family, and you guys are Mary and I's brother and sister in Christ and all that stuff. But it's real easy to feel lonely at times. And one of the saddest songs I think I've ever heard is, "I'm so lonesome I could cry." And there's an old saying that I quickly found to be true is that there's room at the top, meaning where when you work with so many people, whether you're a pastor, a teacher, a physician, a politician, a counselor, where do you go when you help people all day? And then when you lay in your bed and God's blessed you with a big house, and now we know why with my in-laws there and a baby coming and all the different stuff. But this is a song called "Where No Man Stands Alone." And I quickly learned again that God promises to never leave us nor forsake us. He's closer than any brother, and we're never alone. Praise the Lord. Now, I'm going to try to do this. I don't think I've been this nervous since I preached my first sermon back in 2003 on Sunrise Service in 2002. But I'm gonna try. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Here we go. Once I stood in the
let me stand where
alone. Amen. You'll have to tell my father. Maybe I'll finally, after 36 years, he's been wanting me to pick up the train. But he could sit there and play, hear a song one time, and sit down and play just by ear. Mary plays by chord, my mother plays by notes, and I don't know what I do. Praise the Lord. Mariah, Sydney, and Lexi are going to come and sing a song for us now. Praise the Lord. Cindy's going to come and sing her second song tonight.
My prayer is, as I sing this, that maybe
you've gone to church for a long time, or maybe you're in ministry or whatever, that you would be drawn close to the Lord. And maybe if your heart's not right with God, that this would be the day that you draw close. Or maybe you don't know Jesus. And maybe through these words, that you'd be come to learn to know who he is. And I just ask that you listen to the message more than the messenger.
Save me and I will be saved, for you are my praise. Jeremiah 17:14.
Sleep in peace.
come and sing a song called Why Should the Father Bother?
Yeah!
We're coming down the wire now. Praise the Lord.
Remembering you back to 1979 with my son. I've been reading a book for a long time. It's taken me a long time to get my frequency. But this one happens to be called Slave. And it's about being a slave to Christ. And back in the day, there were obviously slaves who were mistreated. The Israelites were held captive by Egypt, and so we know some were mistreated, but there were others who were treated quite well. In fact, they took on their master's professions. Luke was a doctor, because his master once was too. And they were respected and well taken care of. And even when they were sent off, when their 7 years were up or whatever they did, they were sent off with money and things to go off and prove themselves. And it goes even further than that. Yes, Christ paid for us with a price. He paid his life for us. And so that we wouldn't be in bondage to sin anymore. But also way back in the day, there were times when their time was done, they might want to stay with their master and be a bond servant. And that's what we should be doing. And then, even further, there were a few times when the masters would actually adopt this once slave. They were no longer a slave, though. They became part of that household. They were no longer in authority to their home life and the people who used to be in charge of them. But they were now grafted into the family that adopted them. And I think it's really cool that we too are adopted into the family of God by a loving God and a Christ who gave his life for us. And I'm just going to read a little portion of what is in this book. For all who are being led by the Spirit of God, these are sons of God. For you have not received a spirit of slavery leading to fear again, but you have received a spirit of adoption as sons, by which we cry out, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, heirs. Heirs of God and also fellow heirs with Christ, if indeed we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. This passage underscores important truths about the believer's adoption into the family of God. Though we were formerly enslaved to sin and the condemnation of the law, we have been permanently liberated through our adoption into the family of God. As his adopted children, we enjoy the profound privilege of an intimate relationship with our Heavenly Father, to whom we cry out with childlike affection, Abba, which means Daddy. A term of intimate endearment. Abba is an informal Aramaic term for father. It expresses tenderness, dependence, and a childlike assurance that lacks any anxiety or fear. Jesus himself used the term in the Garden of Gethsemane when he poured out his heart to his Father. That we would be allowed to address the Father in the same way Jesus did underscores the magnificent reality of our adoption. To be considered heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ is a remarkable truth and one that we should never take for granted. To think that we who were once the slaves of sin, the subjects of Satan, and the sons of disobedience are now and forever slaves of Christ, the citizens of heaven and the children of God, such is the joy and wonder of salvation. As his enemies, we did not even deserve to be his slaves. Yet, he has made us both his slaves and his children. The incomparable reality of adoption is this: if God is our master, then he is also our father. If we are slaves, then we are sons and heirs of God through Jesus Christ. This is called Why Should the Father Bother? And I am nervous.
Why should the father bother to call us his children? Why should the Spirit hear it should the Father bother to be concerned with all our needs? It's all because of what the Son has done. Once we were lost out on the ocean, with no direction or devotion, tossed about by every wind and wave. Now we are in the world, not of it. We can surely rise above it, because the Lord has risen from the grave.
Sing. This should be the last one from the computer.
Do you remember what the song's called? Sorry. It was a good song. I was listening through it and it really touched my heart, so I thought I would try singing it for Tyler tonight. And Tim McGraw is one of my favorite singers.
I'm dusting off my Bible today. Read the words and read
every word he said.
He talked about forgiveness in a better way. I raised my hands above my head and I said, touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. There was a little girl just down the street. They were praying for a miracle, but running out of hope. Some stranger was an angel.
what you needed. What was plainer today that was 10 years ago. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. That's just another stormy rolling. All he needs is just a little bit of your faith. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Old man was losing his battle with the liquor. His name and brought his family champagne. He stumbled in the church and they found something bigger. He threw at his own game and poured it down the drain. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Just another stormy roll away. All he needs is just a little bit of your faith. And a touchdown, Jesus. Oh, touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Hey, touchdown, Jesus. Oh, touchdown, Jesus. His graduation. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus. Touchdown, Jesus.
I know you're all football fans, so I hope you like that.
And there's certainly a lot of them in here. Redskins could use touchdown Jesus today. And so could the Browns. Amen. Thank you, Mariah. Felicity's going to come now, and she's going to, where's she at? She's over there. She's going to come to the piano. Don't clap too loud, Elizabeth. You're coming next. So you're on deck. All right. So as we finish up, it's great to have all these different folks that know how to play the piano. Amen. Isn't it great to have young people that know how to play the piano and can sing? And so Felicity's going to sing for us here tonight.
Thank you.
pray nobody here wants to go through the motions. Amen. We want to serve Jesus Christ. Elizabeth's going to come and close us out here tonight with a song at the end of herself. And we're going to do that afterwards. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Song, and there's always a lot of times where pastors talking about how God tore the veil when Jesus died, and every time he says that, it reminds me of this song, so I was like, okay, I want to learn this song, and so here it is.
I know you love me.
Lord God, you tore the veil. In Jesus, you said it is done, it is finished. Lord, before we close out with the fun photo competition or contest, Lord, we want to be real serious. Tonight, we've heard a lot about the cross. Lord God, tonight we've heard a lot about who we are in Jesus Christ, the freedom we have in Christ, the life and the more abundance and the victory that we have. But Lord, without the cross, we have nothing. Lord God, without the shedding of your blood, precious Jesus, we have nothing. We have no hope. And Lord God, we want to close this special service out tonight with an invitation for one to come to the cross. Lord, I know that some visitors and other folks have already left, but Lord, you knew who would be here tonight. Lord, yes, we're late, but you're ready to save a soul. Lord God, you're ready to restore a broken heart. Lord, maybe there's one that's thinking about dying. We don't know. Lord God, as Tony and Mariah were singing, all I could think about was what different folks are going through with a troubled and racing mind. But Lord, you are there offering hope tonight. And Lord, if there's somebody here tonight that says, I need hope, I need Jesus in my life, Lord God, I pray that they will receive your invitation. I pray, Lord, that they know that you love them. And Lord God, that even though they're a sinner, you went to the cross for them. You bore it all, and all they have to do is admit that they're a sinner and they need forgiveness and they need to turn from their sin. Believe that you died on the cross. Confess you as Lord and Savior of their life. And Lord, I pray that they'll step out right now. Lord God, if there's anybody here that needs Jesus tonight, maybe it was a song, Lord. Maybe it was a poem. Maybe it was a word that was shared. But Lord God, if there's anybody here, Lord God, tonight that says, I need to know Jesus, a child, a teenager, adult, a senior, anybody here, Lord, that's left, Lord God, that needs to receive the invitation of Jesus Christ, I pray, Lord, that they'll step out right now and come to this altar and, Lord God, to receive Jesus Christ as Lord. For, Lord, you called everyone publicly and you said if we're willing to confess you publicly, you will confess us before our Father. However, Lord, if we deny you publicly, you will deny us before our Father and his angels. Anybody here tonight? The Bible says now, today is a day of salvation. Hallelujah. Anybody? Praise be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we've given an opportunity, Lord God, tonight. Lord, may we continue to plant seeds. And Lord, may you give the increase. Lord God, some water, some plant. But Lord, you give the increase. We just thank you and praise you tonight. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You guys have a good time tonight?
Oh, yeah.
Praise the Lord. I love talent night.